Hi friends, welcome back to today's Thrifty Thursday video. I'm super excited for you guys to join me in today's video. The video today is actually going to be a two-part video, part one of a two-part video. And so this week we're talking about how to save money on groceries, and the following video next week that will be out on Thursday is how to make meal planning easier and give you guys some tips to meal plan without really like meal planning, I guess, and to simplify for you. So if you're interested in seeing the video next week, make sure you subscribe so you do not miss it when it comes out. But today I wanted to share with you guys for Thrifty Thursdays, so of course, some money saving tips is how things that we do or try to implement in our home and how we can try to save money on groceries. Share down below, you guys. I want to know if maybe there's something that I haven't shared. Share down below what's your best way or tips that you have for how you save money on groceries. So let me know, because I really want to know what you guys think as well. So let's get into today's video, and we are going to have 10 tips on how to save money on groceries. Tip number one that I have for you guys is to utilize your freezer. Whether you have just, you know, the little freezer that's in the bottom of your fridge, or you have a whole nother separate freezer like we do now, like in your basement, your garage, wherever, just utilize that freezer. Don't underestimate what you're able to do with it. You can do things, you can freeze foods that would usually maybe go to waste, or if you see that foods are starting to maybe kind of turn, or you know, like they're getting close to maybe the expiration date, or you're worried that like say a bulk soup that you made, maybe you had too much or it's gonna go bad. You can freeze a lot of things like soups, a lot of cheeses. Like if you maybe there was a sale and you bought a big bag of cheese, you're not gonna use it all, you know, in a week or two, definitely put it in the freezer. It can spend the life of your food items for up to weeks and even months. And so definitely use that freezer to help you save money, and that way you're not wasting groceries and throwing them away. Another tip for I have for you is to buy bulk. But make sure, my tip to this, because I know a lot of people say buy bulk, is make sure it's for items that you actually use. Like, you can buy a bulk in a lot of things, right? Because I love Costco. You guys know that I do a lot of Costco hauls for you. I like to buy a lot of other things in bulk, but really make sure that you're buying things that you actually use. Just because it's in bulk and it's on sale and it's a cheaper price and there's a lot of it, doesn't mean that you need it if it's not something that you know your family uses all the time. So for example, like for me, I know that our family, like we use a lot of garlic when I cook. We use a lot of spaghetti noodles. We use, you know, for example, like goldfish snacks, different things like that. I know that if I buy them in bulk, I don't even have to worry about us using them up. We're going to use them up. But things, for example, like sauces and dips, oftentimes I don't actually buy in bulk at Costco, even though per ounce or per pound it is a cheaper and a better value. I do not buy them because I've learned the hard way. I will, like for example, for me, I like the artichoke dip. I actually buy the smaller 16 ounce size at Aldi, which does cost me a little bit more per ounce, but I actually use the whole thing up. It doesn't go bad. Whereas when I bought it at Costco, yes, it was a better value, but it was so big a container that I'm not eating artichoke dip, you know, by the spoonfuls every day. That's kind of more of a specialty dip item for us, that it actually ended up getting moldy and I had to throw it away because I couldn't even finish it by the time, you know. So I just think it's like that, where it's things that you know you're not going to use up all the time, or maybe not as fast, that really don't freeze as well. Like this sauce doesn't freeze the best. So things like that that you know you're not always going to use, do not buy it in bulk, because a lot of times you're going to end up wasting it, or it's going to expire before you even use it up. Buy bulk, obviously, when it's something that you use, and that it's a great way to save money. So do that when it's something you use. Always reiterate that. Don't just buy bulk everything, because it's not the best way to save money. Trust me. Tip number three that I have for you to save money is make sure that you're shopping your pantry, your fridge, and your freezer before you really buy any meals or go out and buy more items. The tip that I have for you is, because oftentimes we have this mentality like, oh my gosh, I have no groceries, I need to buy more. I get that a lot too. But you really slow down, stop, and if you actually look around, like for example, into your freezer, into your pantry, you'll see, oh wait, I actually forgot, you know, I have a frozen pizza in the fridge. That could be a dinner, or in the freezer. Or you could say, oh, I totally forgot, I have, you know, some cream of chicken and some other things, I could make something with that. Like, you start kind of making the connections and you end up actually saving money and extending kind of the days of how long you can wait before you can grocery shop again. And it's a good way to just use up what you actually have in your pantry and in your freezer. And obviously put those two together and you can actually make some really good meals that you may not have thought about when you're just kind of like, oh, my fridge is empty, because sometimes you forget about your freezer and your pantry. So definitely go there first, see if you have any more possible meals, even sides, you know, desserts, things like that, that you can make before you go and buy more groceries. Tip number four that I have for you, I've done a video on this a while ago. You guys know I did a freezer meal day with my friend Molly. I'll try to find the link to that video and share with you guys if you're interested in seeing that. Now, this is not something obviously I do on the weekly, but this is something that I have done and I do recommend for saving money in groceries, is to do either a freezer meal day. You can do it by yourself, obviously. I recommend doing it with a buddy and you split your meals. You kind of do it together. You guys will see the video if you check it out. Do your freezer meal day together. You each take home some meals that are ready to go either in a crock pot or Instapot, and you are ready with some awesome meals. You don't have to worry about getting more groceries for them. Or you can do like the double and freeze method, or make the double of a meal. Like, for example, if you're making soups, like I was like, say, like if you make a big batch of soup, you can cut that in half, put half in the freezer for another meal, and eat obviously the other half that day. So you can do that method as well, and that helps stretch out your meals and helps make it a little bit easier for you, that if you have stuff prepped in the freezer that you double batched, or, you know, freezer meals. But when it's really hard and you're kind of just tired and you want to get tempted to go out to eat, you'll be like, hey, quick, I have, this is my freezer, pull it out, there you go, it's done, just reheat it and we have dinner, and you didn't have to spend money eating out. Tip number five is a very important one that I have for you guys, is to do not impulse shop. This is something I've had to develop and learn, like teach myself over time, because it's hard to just like go in. I feel like, especially when you see things and you're like, oh wait, I think I want to do that. Oh wait, and you see certain spices or certain recipes or certain ingredients, you're like, no, I'm going to do that now. And it's kind of all mismatched in your brain, and then you come home and you're kind of like, why did I buy this? What was I gonna do with this? And then oftentimes those ingredients end up just either going bad or just in your pantry or not being utilized the best way, and they get wasted. And honestly, that's money that's wasted as well. So what I recommend is don't ever impulse shop. I always have a list going. Either you can do it on an app, just on an old fashioned, like on a piece of paper, right? On your fridge, write it down. Have people in your family write it down when things run out. And you will start realizing that you're kind of like the things that you really need and things you want to buy, so that when you're going to Target or wherever, have that list with you on your phone, that paper, that way you're buying those items and you're not getting distracted from what you know you really need to make your meals. And again, that's saving you money on your groceries. To go along with the impulse shopping, something that I mentioned to you guys before, I know I do like my weekly grocery hauls for you, is that I've actually utilized, because sometimes it's hard for me to not impulse shop, especially like at Target, because I get distracted in all the other sections, the dollar section, right? So something that I actually have utilized is Instacart for us. We did a majority of our grocery shopping even before we did Instacart at Aldi, but they didn't ever, I used to deliver. And then a few months ago, Instacart started delivering from Aldi, and I tried it and I loved it. And I actually found that I save more money for me personally, because again, I don't get distracted by that fun middle island Aldi with all like the seasonal or random fun things that I think I need, but I really don't, because if I'm not even thinking about them, obviously I didn't need it. But when I'm in that aisle, I'm like, oh yeah, I need this like 7 set of Tupperware. Like, no, Tanya, just walk away, you know? Like, but again, when I do Instacart, I just order the things I need. I don't see all those other distracting things in the store, and it really helps save me money. So I definitely recommend, if you are able to shop online and have it delivered, or even things like Walmart pickup, you can find some good discounts too. Sometimes they'll offer codes. I will link, share down below in the description, my link for Instacart. If you guys wanna try it out, you'll get $10 off and free delivery, I believe, on your first order if you've never tried it. So if you've been interested in trying it out, I'll have that down below. So, but if, again, like I mentioned, if you are one of those people that does not wanna use a delivery service and you wanna go into the store and actually shop for your groceries every week or every couple weeks, and you wanna use the weekly ads, you know, or things like that, definitely use the weekly ads if you are not using them. Not just, I think they're really helpful, and the tips I would give you is look on the front and look on the back. Not really so much the stuff in the middle, but the front and the back is where the actual really good deals are for that week. So a lot of the produce, the meats, all those things will be on the front and the back. And really basing your meals and what you're going to be eating for that week around those items. A tip I have, if you're able to, is to shop your local markets. For us, I'm not able to do this year round. I live in Minnesota. It's very, very cold, obviously, in the winter. So I'm excited to shop other farmers markets because in the summertime, we have amazing farmers. This is a great way to really support the local economy, the local farmers, and the work that they put into it, but also to get really good local produce that's actually really good quality and a lot of times a very affordable price. So I recommend that really utilize them to get a lot of the produce especially. So I know a lot of times when you eat the vegetables and the fruits that are in season, they're actually a very affordable price. If you just make meals from the things that are in season that are an affordable price, it'll help you save money. And the last two money-saving grocery tips, the first one is to use apps. You guys know I talk about technology and trying to use what we can. So things like Ibotta, if you are going to go into the store, things like Ibotta will help you on items that maybe there's not always a coupon for, or maybe they're not always on sale. So check out Ibotta before you go into the store. I also like the app Checkout 51. Those are kind of ones for groceries that if you are going to use them, if you're shopping in the store, because you can't really use them for, like, you know, if you're gonna have your groceries delivered. So, but if I do go into the store ever, if I need to, I like to check on there to make sure, just for any extra savings. So just be aware of those apps, check them out on there. And I know Ibotta does different stores, not just like Target. I think that they do Target, Walmart, a few other places. Check them out, and they have different categories for like groceries or even non-grocery items as well. Last tip I have for you guys is to bring your own grocery bags into the stores. For one, this is an eco-saving tip, so it's really great for the environment to not use all the plastics and like the plastic bags. I know some places don't even have plastic bags anymore. So just make sure you guys bring your own bags, but also not only is it eco-friendly, but a lot of places will give you a discount. I know most of the places we shop now, I know Target will give you 10% off for every bag. I think it was 10 cents, yeah, for every bag. And I know it seems like 10 cents, but all that really adds up, especially if you think about if you're grocery shopping every week, or even if you have a big family and you think about all those bags that you come out with. Like if you come out with like 10 bags, like that's a dollar right there. And if you do that constantly, like every week, that's a lot of dollars. So those are some tips for you guys. Hope you enjoy them. Hope they gave you some ideas. Again, do what you can and just try your best. Thank you so much. Thank you for those subscribing, and I will see you in my next video. Don't forget, part 2 is next week.